Welcome to the course Introduction to R Programming. In this lecture, I will discuss about matrix operations, part 2. In the earlier lecture, we discussed about the basics of the matrix and some operations and properties of matrix. The outline consisting of, first, I will discuss about matrix multiplication. Then cross product of a matrix, followed by addition and subtraction of matrices, then inverse of a matrix, finally eigenvalues and eigenvectors. After that, concluding tips. Then coming to matrix multiplication, the concept is same as in mathematics matrix theory. Whatever the procedure we are using for calculation of multiplication of matrices, same process is followed, but using our R software, using specific syntaxes and commands, so those can be executed. Now, before proceeding to matrix multiplication, you can recall the creation of the matrix once again. So here, I am creating a matrix X by the syntax matrix of n row equal to 4, comma n column equal to 2, comma data equal to 1:8. That means it takes from 1 to 8 continuous numbers. Then by row equal to true means the matrix filled the given data elements accordingly row wise. So whenever you can execute this command, the output is shown below. Here you can see, so it is 4 by 2 matrix, so it fills all the values 1 to 8 row wise. The first row, it contains first two elements 1 and 2, then second row next to two elements 3 and 4, then third row next to two elements 5 and 6, then fourth row next to two element 7 and 8. So like that you can create the matrix and display the matrix. The right side screen, you can observe, this is the output of the matrix. So after execution in our console. Then coming to, you can recall some basic operations what we covered in the earlier lecture. So here, multiplication of a matrix with a constant. So we already created the matrix X, so that you can multiply with the constant. Then what will happen, each and every element in the matrix that can be multiplied by the given constant. Then the output is shown below. So now these two we already executed in the earlier lecture. So again, here we are reviewing the operations. This is the output shown in this screen. So then coming to matrix multiplication. So this can be implemented by using the operator percentage asterisk percentage. So this symbol is used for multiplication of matrices. So here the multiplication should satisfy a particular condition. In a matrix, let us assume one matrix with order m by n, first matrix, then second matrix order should be n by p. Here you can see the first matrix number of columns should be equal to, in the second matrix, the number of rows. That is the condition of matrix multiplication. So if any two matrices, whatever we are considering, those are all not satisfying this condition, then matrix multiplication is not possible. So now here you can consider the multiplication of a matrix X with a diagonal matrix, let us assume TX. So now first we can create a matrix X as per our previous syntax what we covered, with the values 1 to 8 by the condition row equal to true with 4 rows and 2 columns. So now the output is shown below. Now you can find out the diagonal matrix, so with a diagonal element as well, that is identity matrix. So that can be stored in TX. Now TX equal to DIAG. This is the diagonal matrix command. So DIAG of the data default value is 1. So all the diagonal elements filled with the value whatever we gave here. The number of rows equal to 2, number of columns equal to 2. Then it creates a 2x2 diagonal matrix with the diagonal element as 1, which is identity matrix. Now you can see our the first matrix X, what is its dimension? 4 rows, 2 columns, that is 4x2. Then our diagonal matrix TX, what is its dimension? 2x2. Here you can observe the first matrix order is 4x2, the second matrix order is 2x2. In the first matrix, number of columns, that is 2. Then in the second matrix, number of rows, that is 2. So should be equal. Now it is satisfying. Then the matrix multiplication is possible. So then you can execute the command using the matrix multiplication operator. Here you can see now that result can be stored into another name called as XTX is given. For understanding purpose, both are concatenated. So XTX equal to the first matrix is X, then the operator for matrix multiplication, percentage, asterisk, percentage. So TX, TX is the second matrix, diagonal matrix. Whenever you can type this command, so then simply you can call the result with the name what you used, XTX. So then the multiplication matrix is display. Now you can try to execute this one using our R software. So now you can see. So open our R console window. So now you can execute the commands of matrix multiplication. So first you can create the matrix. So using the syntax, now I'm creating a matrix X equal to matrix of, so with number of rows n row equal to, so here here can observe 4 rows 2 columns, number of rows equal to 4, so number of columns equal to 2, then data equal to C of 1 to 8, 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 8. So this you can use using colon also, data equal to 1:8. Then the condition by row equal to true. So then close the braces. Now the matrix is created. Then you can call the matrix with name X, what you use. This is the matrix, fill the values by row. So row measure. So then you can create one more matrix as a diagonal matrix that can be stored in TX. So with 2x2. So now I am creating diagonal matrix TX equal to DIAG is the command of diagonal matrix. So the default diagonal value is 1. Then n row, number of rows equal to 2. Then number of columns equal to 2. So here it is 2x2. Here no need to mention by row as 2. By default it displays column wise. So now the diagonal matrix TX is created. You can see the matrix. So TX equal to 1 0 0. Now you can apply the multiplication operator by using the operator percentage, asterisk, percentage. The result can be stored into another name. Let us assume the name as XTX. Now I am storing the result of multiplication in XTX equal to, so the you are multiplying X with TX. So X, the multiplication operator symbol, so percentage star percentage, then TX. Now you can call XTX is the name which is used to store the result of the multiplication of X and TX. Then you can call XTX. Now you can see this is the result of multiplication of the two matrices X and T of X. So you can manually calculate it and check out. So this is the output. Like that, we will compute the matrix multiplication. So with given matrix with diagonal matrix. Now we will see another one. So next operation in the matrix multiplication using cross product also. So cross product of a matrix, that can be done by using a function cross prod with the no space. So using this command, you can find out the cross product of a matrix. So we already created a matrix with 1 to 8 by row equal to 2, the same matrix which is available in X. Then you can apply the cross product of X. So then see the results. So here you can apply cross prod of the matrix X. Now this is the cross product of the matrix. So this is the output. Here one important note you have to remember: the command cross product executes the multiplication faster than the conventional method with T of X percentage star percentage X. This is our normal conventional matrix multiplication. So the cross product command executes the multiplication faster than the conventional method. So it will be used for more cases. Then you can see next operation in matrices. So how to add and subtract different matrices, that is matrix addition and subtraction. So in this, one important point we have to remember: whenever you are computing addition and subtraction of matrices, so the matrices of the same dimension can be executed with the usual operators plus and minus. So addition and subtraction of matrices of the same dimensions can be executed with the usual operators plus and minus. Now we can recall our previous matrix X equal to what we created, matrix with 4 rows, 2 columns, with the data elements 1 to 8 with by row equal to true. Then you can call X. So this is the matrix. So now apply the addition and subtraction. So here you can observe, after creating the matrix X with the given data elements with 4 rows and 2 columns. So now here I am performing addition of the same matrix. So the matrix is X. Now again I want to add X to X. So the command is X plus X with usual operator plus. See here X, you can see what is the dimension, 4 by 2. Then you are adding to X again with same dimension. Here we already mentioned addition and subtractions can be taken place with the same dimensions of the matrices. Now X plus X. So each and every element in the first matrix, then that can be added each and every element in the second matrix with the same positions. So now here 1 plus 1, here you will get 2, then 2 plus 2, you will get 4, 3 plus 3, you will get 6, like and so on. Here 8 plus 8, you will get 16 addition. Then another example. So you are adding a multiplication product result to the matrix X. So suppose here you are multiplying X with the constant 4, so that can be written as 4 into X. So that can be added to our original matrix X. Then you will get X plus 4 into X. This is the result. So first execute these two commands. Now here you can call our matrix again. So you can erase previous commands. So you can freshly clear the console and execute the command again. Now we created X. So now here what we are doing, we are adding the matrix with the same dimension. We are adding X with X. Then second time we are adding X with the matrix multiplying with the constant 4. Now X plus 4 into X. Now you can see this is the result. Similarly, now you can see another operation, 4 into X minus X. So execute this command. First it takes 4 into X, then that can be subtracted from the original matrix X. Now you can execute this command. So 4 into X minus X. So you will also calculate manually, observe the results. So then 4 into X minus X. So this is the result. Then another operation with above command, you can add instead of subtraction. Here 4 into x plus x. So now you can recall the previous command, replace minus with plus. Now you can see this is the result, 4 into x plus x. So like that you can perform addition and subtraction of matrices with same dimension. So then coming to once a matrix is created, if you want to access the rows and columns or sub matrix from the given original matrix, so this can be done using the following examples. First, here we are taking another new matrix here with 5 rows and 3 columns. The condition by row equal to true. Here data is 1:15. That means 1 to 15 elements with row wise. Now this is the matrix you can see. Now with this matrix, how to access rows and columns or sub matrix? Here you can observe the first example. So the command is you can call the matrix with whatever the name with square brackets. The first element in the square bracket is row value, comma the second element is column value. So in this example here we called x of 3 comma blank. That means here we called only row value. So then what is meaning of this? The comment is given here, displays whatever the row number, that row value is displayed. Here we mentioned 3, therefore it displays third row. You can see in the above matrix the index is given, this is the first row, then second one indexing, this is the second row, then third one is indexed with the third row. So here what you mentioned, third row and column is blank, then it displays only third row all values. So in third row what it contains, 7 8 9. Here see, it displays 7 8 9. So it displays in the form of vector only whenever you can call a single row or a single column. Now another second example you can see here, we are calling x of, now row is blank now, comma 2. Now column value is given 2, that is second position. Means it displays the second column values from the above matrix. In the second column you can see, this is second column, what it contains, 2 5 8 11 14. But it won't display as per column format. It displays the column values in the order in the form of vector, that is row format only. So 2, the first one is 2, second one is 5, third one is 8, fourth one is 11, fifth one is 15. Like that it displays. So you can access a particular row value, a particular column value, then a combination of both also you will find out. But that is a submatrix. Here you can see the third example, x of 4:5, comma 2:3. So first of all, what is meaning of this? So in this command, only two values will take. The first value is by default row, second value is column value. So in the row position, what they gave, 4:5. So that means it displays the submatrix of fourth and fifth rows. So here it displays fourth and fifth rows, comma, then columns positions also given. So the column positions 2:3, then respective fourth and fifth rows, then it displays second and third column values. So in the comment also given here, so it displays the submatrix of 4 to 5 rows and 2 to 3 columns. Now you can see in the original matrix X, you can observe the fourth row, this is fourth row 10, 11, 12. Then this is the fifth row 13, 14, 15. So in this, the second column, you can see what it contains respective 11 and 14. Then third column 12 and 15 only. This part is displayed. Now this is called as the submatrix of the given original matrix X. So now you can execute this command using our R software. First, we can create the matrix with these values. Now you can erase this command. Then you can copy this command. Then you can clear console. Then you can type. So now you can recall. Then you can try. So here the matrix, what it contains. So how many rows? So it contains 5 rows, 3 columns. Now rows equal to 5. Then columns, number of columns are 3. Then data is 1:15. So instead of giving C of with all values, if it is continuous data, simply you can give 1:15. Here by row equal to true. Now you can call X. See the matrix, row matrix is created. So now here what operation we performed? So you can use any position. First you want to display, I want to display the first row of this matrix. You can see one comma empty. So 1, 2, 3 first row. Then I want to display the second row of this matrix. So then the second row is 4, 5, 6. Then I want to display a third row. So the third row is 7, 8, 9. Then I want to display a last one, fifth row. So you can give 5 comma blank 13, 14, 15. Similarly, if you want to display a particular column row, you can make it as blank, then column value. I want to display the first column. First column values will be displayed in the form of vector in the order 1, 4, 7, 10, 13. Now I want to display suppose third column. You can give row as empty, column as 3. So 3, 6, 9, 12, 15 will be displayed. Now if you want to find out the submatrix, so I want the submatrix of 3 to 5. Now I am taking 3 to 5. That means 3 to 5th row, third, fourth and fifth rows. Then I will take 2 to 3 columns. Then you can see the submatrix. Here you can observe third row 7, 8, 9. Fourth row 10, 11, 12. Fifth row 13, 14, 15. Then second column and third column. Second column, what it contains, respective 3, 4, 5. So 8, 11, 14. Then third column 9, 12, 15. So then the submatrix is displayed here. So like that we will find the submatrices. So like this we will access to rows, columns or submatrices using these commands. So then coming to our next important operation of a matrix, how to find out inverse of a matrix. So to find inverse of a positive definite matrix, we'll use the function SOLVE. So with the function brackets. So now within bracket you can give the name of the matrix. So it finds the inverse of only a positive definite matrix. For example, again you can create a new matrix, name it as Y. Y equal to matrix with 2 rows and 2 columns by the condition row is true. Here the data equal to C of 84, 100, 100, 120 with 4 values, 2 by 2 matrix. So whenever you can execute this command, you can call the matrix. So it displays the 2 by 2 matrix with the values filled with row wise, 8400 in first row, 100, 120 second row. Then you can use this command solve within bracket, use the name of the matrix, whatever we used. So here we used Y as the matrix name, you can use Y. Then this is the inverse of the matrix. So you can find out manually also, check out. So this is the inverse of the matrix Y. So again, here we are repeating the matrix multiplication. The matrix Y multiplied with the inverse of the matrix, that is solve of Y. So matrix multiplication operator is percentage star percentage. So this is the multiplication of the matrix Y with the inverse matrix. This is the multiplication result. Now you can execute this operation, solve function to find inverse of a matrix. Now you can create a matrix with 2 by 2. Now you can erase this browser. Now we are creating a matrix Y equal to matrix of your number of rows equal to 2, n row equal to 2, number of columns equal to 2, n column equal to 2. Then by row condition is true. So true or false, you can use capital T or capital T R U, capital F or capital F A L C. Then data equal to C of. So here what they give, 84, 100, 100, 120. 84, 100, 100, 120. So four values are given. So then you can execute this command. Simply call y. This is the matrix created. Now you are finding inverse of this matrix y. Simply you can use the command solve within bracket the name of the matrix, that is y. Now this is the inverse of the matrix. Now again here computing the multiplication of the matrix y with the reverse of the matrix. So y, the multiplication operator, percentage, asterisk percentage, then the inverse of the matrix is solve of y. Now this is the multiplication of the matrix and its inverse. This is the result. Like that we will compute inverse of a matrix using the solve function. So this is the output screen included here, what we seen in the demonstration. Then you can find out to coming to our next topic. So in matrices, how to find out eigenvalues and eigenvectors? It's a very important one. So here the function eigen within brackets eigen finds both eigenvalues and eigenvectors of a positive definite matrix, same as inverse. For inverse also, here it concerns only a positive definite matrix. For example, so whatever the matrix you can take, earlier matrix whatever you created y equal to, same matrix you can call. Then simply you can use the eigen function eigen within brackets name of the matrix. Then it decomposes the eigen function into two parts. So one is values, second one is vectors. So that we call it as eigen values. Then vectors are called as eigen vectors. So whenever you can execute, so these are all the two parts it contains. One is eigen values and the second part is eigen vectors. I can execute this function. So here already we created y. You can again recall y. The matrix y appears here. Now using the function eigen eigen within brackets, you can simply give the name of the matrix. Now it produces, here you can see. So eigen decomposition with the two parts. One is values, second one is vector. So values can be displayed in the form of vector one by one. There is a vector in the form of matrix, multiple values. So like that we can find out eigenvalues and eigenvectors. So in the matrices using the function eigen. So this is the output screen. What we see, same thing is included here. Okay, in this lecture, that's all about the topics what we covered as part of basics of calculations. What we covered some matrix operations. So here, coming to conclusion, there are so many matrix operations available. So my objective is not to teach you here the matrix theory. My objective is simply to help you that how you can do these matrix operations using our R software. So some engineers might have a different type of requirement than those who are dealing statistics or say it mathematics, but these are the basic fundamentals by which you can do your program. So now I will stop here, but now you have to start and you can go as far as you want.